This video will show you how to terminate the Leviton Cat 6A tool-free plug on an unshielded twisted pair category 6A cable. Standard hand tools are used for cable preparation, but the plug can be terminated without any tools and can be used for shielded or unshielded application. The Cat 6A tool-free plug comes with the following parts: the internal circuit board and wire manager, the plug body, the plug cover, and the rear nut. To prepare the wires for termination, we'll use the following tools: a data wire strip tool and a flush cutter. Additional tools you may find useful are needle nose pliers, channel lock pliers, and a small flat blade screwdriver. Unscrew the square component from the nut. Slide the nut onto the cable, then the square component, making sure none of the teeth slip under the cable jacket. Screw the two pieces together loosely. To strip the cable, position the data cable strip tool about 2 inches from the end of the cable and make a cut using a single circular motion. Be careful not to nick the conductors. Break the cable jacket and slide it off. Cut out any non-pair elements. Cat 6A cable may contain a traditional cross separator, filler tubes, a mylar layer, or a strip string. In this case, the tape between two of the pairs must be removed. Inspect the wire pairs to make sure you didn't damage the insulation or conductor during cable preparation. To straighten out the wires, grasp each pair near its base and untwist it. As you untwist the pair, slide your fingers along both wires in the pair to smooth out any kinks. Don't drag a tool along the conductors to straighten them, as it can flatten and distort the conductors, affecting the transmission quality of the cable. We will be terminating using a T568B wiring method. To load the wire manager, start by trimming the ends of the blue and brown pairs at a slight angle. Then trim the green and orange pairs at an angle, cutting them shorter than the blue and brown pairs. This will make it easier to thread the wires into the wire manager. Thread the blue and brown wire pairs through the appropriate holes, following the diagram on the label. Flip the wire manager over and thread the green and orange pairs. Slide the wire manager down the wires. If you encounter any resistance, use needle nose pliers to gently pull the wires through. To terminate the plug, squeeze the wire manager firmly onto the internal circuit board. Use the flush cutter to trim all 8 wires flush with the front of the wire manager. Place the terminated plug assembly into the plug body. Make sure the assembly is aligned with the front end of the body. Slide the nut forward to engage the square component with the slot at the back of the plug body. Insert the hinge points of the plug cover under the hooks found at the front of the plug body. Press the plug cover down over the nut and squeeze it until the plug cover arms are fully engaged with the plug body. If you have trouble fully closing the plug cover, use channel lock pliers to gently squeeze each corner into place. Be sure to compress the body, not the plug's latch. Screw the nut onto the back of the plug. The plug is now ready for testing. To disassemble the plug, unscrew the nut and slide it back along the cable. Insert a small flat blade screwdriver into each of the latch points at the back of the plug and gently rotate until the plug cover pops off. If the latch points become bent, use channel lock pliers to gently squeeze them straight. Lift the internal circuit board wire manager off of the plug body. Then insert a flat blade screwdriver between the circuit board and the wire manager. Taking care not to damage the circuit board or any of the contacts, use the screwdriver to lift both sides of the wire manager with slight twisting motion. Slide the wire manager off of the wires. The plug is now ready for re-termination. To learn how to terminate the Cat 6A tool-free plug on a shielded cable, an instructional video is available at leviton.com.